Folks, have you ever noticed how aggressively average fat-bellied, double-chinned, beer-drinking, meat-eating douchebags react when somebody cool comes up and says, usually smiling, "You know, I went veggie, and you can give up meat too." Perhaps if you're not vegan, chances are you've never really picked up on that. And the reaction goes, "Wait a minute, what do you mean give up meat? What are you talking about? Are you freaking kidding me? Come on, man, don't be ridiculous. Like, what am I supposed to eat on this crappy diet? Am I supposed to starve to death or what?" Funnily enough, these 400-pound monsters with bellies ominously sucking well over the belt buckles are always preoccupied with starving to death. And that's a typical reaction you're gonna get from an average, self-righteous, uninquisitive and bigoted individual. Believe it or not, even most reasonable people actually do react like this too. However, once you just give it a try, you'll be pretty quick to discover there are plenty of meatless options out there. You'll be amazed at the abundance of vegan foods. I dare you, just punch in on any search engine, vegan recipes, and it's going to turn up a host of excellent online cookbooks with just delicious recipes, which can also be dairy-free and even without eggs in them. By the way, do you guys know what the trickiest thing about changing your eating habits is? Any ideas? Well, I'll tell you that the trickiest thing about changing your eating routines is, at first, you tend to be quite skeptical about it, right? You can go, that honestly doesn't seem convincing enough. It seems totally unsustainable. Is it even possible to follow? And once you've taken that first practical step, you'll find it perfectly doable, more than possible, and, which is more, great fun. Above all, changing your eating routines is just great fun. Still, you can hear some obviously undereducated Westerners go, "Well, where do I get my protein from? I'm not so sure I can subsist on rice, veggies, carrots, apples, bananas, or what have you." Oh, there we go again, baby. Sure you can. For goodness sake, you can. In fact, just as we speak, some Japanese guys on the island of Okinawa are eating precisely a diet of rice, some veggies, and some fruit. And they manage to live to be 100, as opposed to their smug Western counterparts who are stuffing their faces with barbecues, steaks, nuggets, pork chops, double bacon cheeseburgers, super jumbo hamburgers, scrambled eggs, smoked salmon, milk, and who barely make it to their 80s, most dying in their 60s, or with luck, 70s. Suffering from severe cases of gastrointestinal and cardiovascular malfunctions, mental disorders, and cancers. Now, am I the only person here who thinks it's at the very least worth giving a thought to? Ladies and gentlemen, I can still remember it vividly. I was waiting for my scheduled appointment with a general practitioner when suddenly a bloke frantically darted out of the doctor's room and yelled to the patients in the waiting hall, "You know what? Don't make these bastards wealthy, make yourselves healthy." It all happened almost in a blink of an eye, on a freezing cold February night in 2009. I was rushed to a hospital with shooting abdominal pain. In fact, it hurt so bad I could barely breathe. After ultrasound, blood tests, X-rays, CT were performed, I was diagnosed with acute pancreatic necrosis. A sobering medical verdict for a 21-year-old kid. It sent a chill through my family and friends. My parents raced to take a month off and traveled to the hospital as quickly as possible to sit by my bedside and take up the issue with my doctors. And actually, to buy them. But shush. Now, have you guys ever felt like you were doing something dead wrong to your body? Nutrition-wise, I mean. Have you ever experienced a feeling like that? If so, so have I. If only you could imagine how willing I was to give all it took to reverse the illness through changing my eating habits and rethinking my whole lifestyle too. Now, I believe you should know my nutritional background. Prior to that episode, I'd been consuming an altogether typical omnivore diet. Bucketfuls of red meat, pork, poultry, fish, dairy, eggs. Animal protein, essential amino acids, you know what I'm talking about, don't you? At the time, though, I didn't. Rather, I was following somewhat automatically. It was a kind of a default mode to me. In a manner of speaking, it was my best bet. And I'd been stuck with it. And there I was. I spent an entire month lying on a hospital bed, hooked up to all those almost all day long drip bags. And I was discouraged to even drink water for the first 3 days of my stay there. I didn't eat a crumb for a fortnight. When I was finally being discharged from the hospital, the doctors prescribed me a strict pancreatic diet. Let's see what we have here. You should avoid excessive fats. That is, roast, oily, spicy, smoked, pickled foods. But at the same time, you should take in, on a daily basis, blonde red meat, boiled chicken breasts, medium fat cottage cheese, low fat fish, low fat dairy. Little did I know back then, it was a recipe for disaster. A year and a half later, I developed a new episode of acute pancreatitis. Goodness me, what in the world may have gone so terribly wrong? I was thinking to myself. Indeed, I'd been following most diligently the dietary recommendations I'd been prescribed and still ended up on a hospital bed. Clueless, I continued on with a medically approved diet, which got me into trouble and for which I was paying so heavy a price in the first place, so I continued on with it, but of course to no avail. In a couple of months' time, my pancreas struck yet again, and then again, and again. All in all, I sustained 3 more inflammations. To make matters even worse, though, my gallbladder followed suit. And by the age of 24, I already had chronic pancreatitis and chronic cholecystitis under my belt. Way too much, folks. Take my word for it. And it wasn't until some 16 months later that I discovered a vegetarian option. It all happened as follows. My best friend, smart and caring as he is, once Skyped me, saying, "You know, animals are treated in all the wrong ways, and to stay out of supporting this industry of slavery and torture and death, I went veggie. Look," he then added, "given all your health problems, why don't you try this out?" Indeed. I thought, cute idea. Why not? And that is when I started to read up extensively on slaughterhouses, where animals are kept enslaved, and in pain, and tortured to death. And it caused me to switch to a vegan lifestyle. See, you definitely need to know something about me. I've never been a bully. In fact, just the opposite is true. Oftentimes I was bullied. I was attacked and mocked for no good reason at all, just for being the person I was. So I do know what it feels like to be victimized. And I, in turn, have never attacked or hurt anyone who hasn't done anything wrong to me. And animals obviously didn't do anything wrong to me. So why on earth, then, am I slyly paying somebody else to enslave, harass, torture, murder, and season them for me to just have a nice steak or a pork chop on my plate? Isn't it too wicked and too solipsistic? Don't you think so? I thought along those lines, and I went veggie chiefly for ethical reasons, without even giving too much of a thought to how it might affect my health. However, it did affect my health, dramatically so. Little by little, I began assembling data on what animal foods really brought along and what meat and dairy industry and physicians tamed or fooled by them would never, ever, never want any of us to find out. For one, alongside fabled animal proteins and essential amino acids, shitloads of deadly cholesterol, baneful saturated fatty acids, pus, hormones, antibiotics, carcinogenic neurotoxins, the poisons of decaying flesh, and on top of that, even particles of feces. Sounds delicious, doesn't it? Feces on your dinner plate. Decaying dead body on your dinner plate. If that does sit right with you, then enjoy your meal, mate. However, it didn't sit quite well with me. Moreover, independent and unbiased research findings suggest animal protein brings us far more harm than it does good. For instance, it significantly boosts the release of somatomedin C, a hormone encoded by the IGF-1 gene, and casein, the type of protein found in dairy products, actually synthesizes opiates in our organism. Excessive intake of animal protein alone, something the vast majority of people indulge in on a daily basis, has been conclusively linked to the onset of most chronic gastrointestinal diseases. Oh, you say, who gives a shit? Well, add up to it cardiovascular maladies, heart attacks, strokes, mental disorders, prostate cancer, diabetes, and you've lumped together the whole clinical picture. Here's one thing I want all of you to realize. Medical doctors everywhere in the Western world are trained to address the symptoms and not to treat the root causes of diseases, let alone prevent them. Disease prevention? What's that? Oh, never mind, Dr. Jones. As a famous wartime surgeon, Dennis Burkitt, once put it, you can turn off the watering tap, or you can keep mopping wet floor on and on till you drop. The latter stands for what medical doctors are encouraging you to do, whereas the former, that is, shutting the watering tap, is what you can do, should you take the responsible risk of thinking for yourselves. Mainstream Western medicine folks will never benefit from your health, but rather it will forever thrive on your unhealth. Both economically and politically, you are programmed to make them wealthy, not yourselves, healthy. And in doing so, you're assigned the dirty and nasty role of partners in crime, murdering sentient beings and destroying the ecosystems of planet Earth. Apart from that, keeping you sick is what essentially keeps them going, and to keep you sick, they first need to keep you, guess what, misinformed or even completely in the dark. Meat and dairy lobbies are blissfully tapping into your ignorance. And their lies actually cajole you into being dangerous and savage badasses. Burger joints, pizzerias, and other restaurants such as McDonald's, Burger King, Taco Bell, Wendy's, Fridays, KFC, Domino's, Papa John's, or what have you, are not going to tell you meat on direct deleterious to your health. Apparently, it's not in their best interest. Goldman Sachs, AIG, Citigroup, and other giant corporations running global economy are not going to admit it either, and are highly unlikely to fund unbiased research or bankroll anti-meat and anti-dairy campaigns. Rather, on the contrary, they'd love you to keep buying and devouring meat, fish, dairy and eggs on and on, day in, day out, till your arteries finally get clogged and your neuronal synapses disrupted by deadly cholesterol, so that you can no longer think clearly and eventually contract Alzheimer's or dementia. And go vote for these ugly wankers and give away all your saved money to medical and pharmaceutical industries. That's exactly what they are expecting from you. And I'm afraid their flagrant lies are going to be uncovered and exposed at an official level all too late. It will take long, ladies and gentlemen, before it finally happens. But good news is, public ignorance can be cured at a personal level, and done so through knowledge and self-education. And if this type of knowledge, supported by airtight scientific evidence, doesn't really make you redefine for yourselves what healthy nourishment is, it implies that you are probably either sadomasochistic or eager to learn from your own painful experience. To reiterate, I had a bitter experience with it, and have since preferred to be reasonable. Once I made that switch to vegan nutrition, I've become pain-free most of the time. See, I used to be a fat ass, 240 pounds of excessive fat and excessive muscle, and that's all gone. That's no longer an issue for me. And I haven't caught a cold for 3 years. No longer do I need to buy expensive pills from chemist counters to keep myself afloat. Furthermore, as time went by, I began gradually getting rid of high blood pressure, something that had haunted me for years. And I feel the vigor and passion to stand here in front of you and to address you, and I believe you're just the right audience. I hope you are hungry for knowledge, willing to think critically, and to change your lives for the better, making a statement and a difference in this freaking world. So veganism, I trust, is the message for you. Now that it's becoming crystal clear, only a skeptical mind can embrace it. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm urging you to behave rationally, to think critically and independently, and to demand intellectually sound, scientific, hard evidence for every bit of information, for every idea and every concept. Someone from a TV screen, or with a medical degree, or just with medical scrubs on, is trying to fob off on us. Just remember, don't make them wealthy. Instead, make yourselves healthy. Thank you so much. Have a lovely day.